Welcome to Snowflake.
This video introduces the architecture and key concepts of the Snowflake Cloud Data Warehouse. Snowflake is the first analytic database built for the cloud. Delivered as a data warehouse as a service, Snowflake runs on the most popular cloud providers. Snowflake is faster, easier to use, and far more flexible than traditional data warehouses. Snowflake handles all aspects of authentication, configuration, resource management, data protection, availability, optimization, and more. As a Snowflake customer, you simply sign up, load your data, and start querying. How does Snowflake differ from other traditional architectures? Shared disk architectures use multiple nodes to access data shared on a single storage system. Shared nothing architectures store a portion of the data in each node and each cluster in the data warehouse. Snowflake combines the benefits of both architectures in an innovative new design that takes full advantage of the cloud. Snowflake's multi-cluster shared data architecture consists of three separate layers: data storage, compute, and a service layer that manages it all. Each layer scales independently and includes built-in redundancy. How does it work? Let's take a look at each layer. Snowflake stores all data in databases. A database is a logical grouping of objects, consisting primarily of tables and views, organized into one or more schemas. Similar to other databases, you can store any structured relational data in Snowflake tables using standard SQL data types. In addition, Snowflake's variant data type lets you store semi-structured, non-relational data, such as JSON, Parquet, and so on. Regardless of your data types, you use ANSI standard SQL to perform all data-related tasks. Snowflake uses highly secure cloud storage to maintain all your data. As data is loaded into tables, Snowflake converts it into an optimized, columnar, compressed format and encrypts it using AES 256 strong encryption. The compute layer is where queries are executed using resources provisioned from a cloud provider. Unlike traditional architectures, Snowflake allows you to create multiple independent compute clusters called virtual warehouses that all access the same data storage layer without contention or performance degradation. To create a virtual warehouse, you simply give it a name and specify a size. Snowflake handles all the provisioning and configuration of the underlying compute resources. A virtual warehouse can be scaled up or down at any time without any downtime or disruption. When a virtual warehouse is resized, all subsequent queries take advantage of the additional resources. Snowflake's unique cloud architecture enables virtually unlimited scale and concurrency without resource contention. For example, separate virtual warehouses can be used to handle loading and querying concurrently. Because virtual warehouses access the same data storage layer, any updates or inserts become immediately available to all other warehouses. The services layer coordinates and manages the entire system. It authenticates users, manages sessions, secures data, and performs query compilation and optimization. The services layer also manages virtual warehouses and coordinates data storage updates and access, ensuring that, once a transaction is completed, all virtual warehouses see the new version of the data with no impact on availability or performance. A key component of the services layer is the metadata store, which powers a number of unique Snowflake features, including zero-copy cloning, time travel, and data sharing. These features will be described in later videos. The services layer is fully maintained by Snowflake, using resources distributed across multiple availability zones to ensure high availability. You can connect securely to Snowflake through any of the provided clients, such as the JDBC or ODBC driver. Snowflake also provides a command line client and web interface. A growing ecosystem of external tools include native connectivity with Snowflake. Virtually, all operations in Snowflake can be performed through these clients. To illustrate the different layers working together, let's walk through the lifecycle of a query. After connecting to Snowflake through one of the supported clients and initiating a session, specify the virtual warehouse to use in the session and submit a query. The services layer validates you are authorized to access the data in the database and perform the operations specified in the query. It then creates an optimized query plan. Next, the services layer sends the query execution instructions to the virtual warehouse, which allocates resources, requests any needed data from the storage layer, and executes the query. The results are then returned to you. What do you need to manage Snowflake? Not much. Snowflake eliminates most of the tuning knobs and parameters required by other data warehouses. As demonstrated in this video, you only need to create databases, tables, and virtual warehouses, load data, and execute queries. Snowflake handles the rest. How much does Snowflake cost? Pricing is based on usage. You pay only for the storage and compute resources you use. Storage costs are based on the amount of compressed data stored in database tables plus the additional data retained to support Snowflake's unique data recovery features. Compute costs are based on warehouse size and how long the warehouse runs. For full details of Snowflake pricing, see snowflake.com. This concludes this introduction to Snowflake's architecture and key concepts. For more details, see the other videos in the Getting Started series and the Snowflake documentation. Thanks for watching.